ready to blow the papers. Join me one last time for us to pray the glory to God together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Please pray the glory to God prayer with me, looking at your neighbors. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. We are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserved her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated.
Sing joyfully to the Lord all the days, break into song, sing praise. has blessed us in regards to every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in the name before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself in Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the name. In him, we were also chosen, destined to be one of the witnesses of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist in the grace of his glory, who we first told in Christ, the word of the Lord.
I am the Lord.
Clumsy and bumbler, and
Lincoln, from his position on the floor, simply looked up at him and said, "Young man, what is troubling you on the inside?" Sometimes we encounter people who act this way, people who act in ways that are disrespectful, or maybe even evil. And if we're trying to be nice about it, kind of like Lincoln was, we might say, "Well, I guess this person has issues." We might say that, "Well, the person acts that way, but you never know what kind of stuff a person is dealing with." I guess we all have our issues and our stuff, but imagine, what would a person be like if the person had no issues, had no stuff at all? What if a person never had any childhood trauma, had never been terrified by a family member, or hurt by abuse, or scared of someone in the home and how they're going to act when they get home or if they come home drunk? What if there's a person who never experienced neglect as a child and never came to think that they were unworthy of attention or love? What if there was a person who had never been abandoned and so never thought that a disagreement might mean the end of a relationship? What if there was a person who was never made fun of or bullied and so had no fear about making friends with anybody? And further, what if there was a person who did not have the normal kinds of problems on the inside that just about everybody experiences? What if a person never had the problem of getting so fixated on the joy or pleasure of the moment that the long-term consequences of the will of God never entered his mind? What if there was a person who never even thought about treating another like an object? What if there was someone who never told lies to himself, never put on a fake front, never had the idea enter his or her mind that he could be a valuable person just by having valuable things? What if there was someone who never wanted to make himself feel superior by looking down on other people? And finally, what if there was a person who was not only free from all these negative tendencies, but who actually had the opposite tendencies, who had a heart filled with love and goodness? What if there was a person whose natural tendency was always to see the best in everyone, to feel hurt when others felt hurt, to always keep self-control, to think before acting? Even more, what if someone had a natural kind of closeness with God, who walked with God every day as a friend, just as Adam and Eve had walked with God in the garden? What if someone lived from the earliest point of his or her life in the presence of God and spoke to him as easily as you and I speak to each other? What would this person be like? What would it be like to have this person as a friend? I can tell you that such a person did indeed walk the face of the earth. And if I ask you the person's name, you might say Jesus, and you would be right. But there was another person too who, like Jesus, was fully human, but unlike Jesus, not a divine person, and that is Mary, his mother. Our Catholic faith tells us that Mary was, to use a very important and precise theological term, Mary was immaculately conceived. It means that from the very first moment of her existence, she was protected from original sin. This also means that, unlike us who need to receive the gift of sanctifying grace in baptism, Mary had grace from the first moment of her existence when she was conceived in the womb of her mother, St. Anne. It also means that she did not have the spiritual wounds in her intellect and will that come from original sin. She did not have the darkness of the mind from original sin, that kind of spiritual brain fog that prevents us from understanding our dignity as God's children and how we live according to that dignity. She did not have the woundedness of the will that leads people to fail to do the good they want and to do instead the evil they don't want. She had, by a special gift from God, the freedom to be the kind of human being God had always meant human be. She radiated joy, love, and the presence of God. Thus, when the angel Gabriel came to visit her, she was prepared for his message. You might say that she had been prepared for it from the first moment of her conception, the very beginning of her existence. In the beginning, God had created a world and gave it to the first human beings, Adam and Eve, as their domain. By their sin, you might say, they excluded God from his world, and by rejecting his authority over them, opened the world to pain, death, and the terrifying evil that is the devil. But now, the time had come for God to come back into his world, to send his son to become a member of the human race, to suffer, die, and rise again, and thus conquer the devil and reclaim the world for God and for all humanity. But God would not impose his plan on humanity. He wanted to come back into this world through one person who would welcome him back, one person who loved him purely, one person who, unlike Adam and Eve, was completely trusting and perfectly obedient to his will. That person was Mary. She was truly a free person. She could have said no, but she did not. For the sake of us, she embraced the Word, the second person of the Holy Trinity, with all the eagerness with which she had always embraced the Word of God in the Scriptures. She was the door that welcomed God back into the world, and her body became a living temple, a holy dwelling, and a home for the Son of God. On this feast day of the Immaculate Conception, I encourage all of us to love Mary and to ask for her intercession. Some people wonder, how can I love Mary when she is so different from me? She is so perfect, sinless, and immaculately conceived, and I have such a hard time being good, and I bear wounds of original sin, and even the weight of my own sins. How can I relate to someone so different from myself? Let me give you an example that may help. Suppose there was an island in the middle of an ocean, and on that island there was some kind of a poison in the drinking water that harmed everyone, making everyone on the island deaf from the time they were born. Then one here perfectly, but the other one happens to be, by some strange chance, deaf, like the people on the island. The person who is deaf will be able to feel compassion for the people of that island, because he, also being deaf, can relate to their experience. But the person who's able to hear also has a way to show empathy and to be compassionate. His heart breaks for the deaf people on the island because he realizes that they will never hear music, never hear the chirping of a bird or the sound of the waves, never hear the voice of a close friend or family member saying, "I love you." You might say that Mary relates to us and has compassion for us, like that second person who has compassion for the deaf, even though he is fully able to hear. Mary's heart is filled with understanding and compassion for us and our guilt, our sins, and our brokenness, even though she is pure and free from original sin. She does feel for us. She wants to help us find our way to the healing and blessing that is meant for us and is waiting for us. If you feel far from God, she has compassion for you, and she wants to help you find the peace of the Holy Spirit. If you struggle with purity, she feels for you, and she wants you to experience joy, dignity, and freedom from shame. If you are selfish, materialistic, or addicted to streaming video, she wants to help you experience the presence of God in relationships, to enjoy the beauty of God's creation, and to create your own stories and treasured memories with family and friends. If you never experienced the faithful and unconditional love of a mother, she wants to be your spiritual mother, and to show you that her presence and her love is not imaginary, but real. She may not be able to share your life experiences in some ways, but she truly does understand you. She loves you, and she wants you to share her experiences in other ways, her freedom, her joy in the Holy Spirit, her delight in the presence of her Son, her power over demons, her generous compassion, her love. So while it is true that we all have our stuff, our issues, our problems, and then Mary, by a special favor from God, is none of these, she is not distant from us, or unable to relate to us, or so far above us in holiness that she cannot understand us. Quite the contrary, she is in the perfect position to help us and bring our prayers to the throne of Christ, her Son. She knows our pain, our brokenness, our poverty, our weakness, our trauma, our anxiety, our emptiness, and she is ready to help us to heal and to experience the favors and blessings that she has always enjoyed. She wants her peace to be your peace, her joy to be your joy, her wholeness to be your wholeness, her heaven to be your heaven. Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to you. Help us, lead us to Jesus, your Son. We are so blessed to have you as our spiritual mother.
Citizens and leaders alike, for the President of Congress, for collaboration with leaders as they work to protect and enhance the gift of democracy, we pray to the Lord. For the members of the Cotton Club community, for a deeper desire to live as they live to recognize the angels who are God's messengers, pay attention to the movement of God at large, we pray to the Lord. For those who face unplanned pregnancies, for those who yearn for children, those unfulfilled, for all those who await childbirth, we pray to the Lord. For openness to unconditional and unlimited grace, to the treasure of Advent, to see both in stillness and our active lives, Christ's presence among us, we pray to the Lord. work, for the intercession of Mary our Mother, for those hearts who are broken, we pray to the Lord. For the sake of our community and all whom we have promised our prayers, for those who face daily addictions in their lives and depression, for those who contribute or any time, and for the intentions we have gathered here in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord God, you have chosen Mary from among all women to be the mother of your Son. We gather on this day in
remembrance of her,
ever grateful for her place in our story of faith. May we too be the attention to your messages of faith. May we ponder the things we do with trust that one day all things will be revealed. Most of all, may we imitate Mary's steadfast faith in your Son. In times of joy and times of heartache, remember Mary's trust and imitate her acceptance of your will, so that we too may be instruments of love and signs of faithfulness in this world. We ask in his name. Amen. Thank you. right and just, I will do that our salvation. Always, everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God. For you preserve the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, in God with the rich, fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your son, and signify the beginning of the church, his beautiful bride, without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth a son, the innocent man, who would wipe away our offenses. You placed her above all others, before your people, an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one body that we serve. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Go and die in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who lead you throughout the ages. We may learn to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, and his Father, in the unity of the
away sins of the world. Blessed are those who all do suffer. Thank you.
Come down